गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, दिस इज पूजा शर्मा ब्रिंगिंग टू यू द टॉप न्यूज ऑफ द वीक। अहेड ऑफ द असेंबली इलेक्शंस इन 2022, बहुजन समाज पार्टी चीफ मायावती सेड द पार्टी विल फाइट स्टेट असेंबली इलेक्शन अलोन इन उत्तर प्रदेश एंड उत्तराखंड। शी ऑल्सो सेड दैट रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ AIMIM एंड द BSP फाइटिंग द असेंबली इलेक्शंस इन UP टुगेदर इज कम्प्लीटली फॉल्स। Party chief Mayawati tweeted refuting reports that her party plans to tie up with Asuddin Owaisi lead AIMI in the state. She also said party has only announced a political tie up with Shiromani Akali Dal for the Punjab elections also held be next year. The two parties have also finalized the seat sharing agreement in the 117 members assembly. AIMIM has earlier claimed that they will fight the upcoming Uttar Pradesh election with the Bahujan Samaj Party and will work as a force against BJP. Similarly, Samajwadi Party chief Akhilesh Yadav had also said a few weeks earlier that there will be no alliance with BSP and the party will like to tie up with smaller parties and like-minded people. In view of the ongoing COVID-19 infection and the fear of a third wave of the pandemic, the Maharashtra government issued guidelines for celebrating Ganesh Utsav. As per the guidelines issued, the state government has kept the maximum ideal height of Ganpati at 4 feet both for the public Ganesh mandals. Besides, the government has laid thrust on giving importance to health camps or blood donation drives instead of culture or entertainment programs during the upcoming 10 days festival beginning September 10. The public mandals have been advised to switch over the online darshan or rallies for the celebration through social media platforms, website or local cable television networks. This is the second consecutive year when the state government has imposed restriction in view of the COVID-19 pandemic. The DGCA has extended the ban on scheduled international flights till July 31. DGCA said the ban on international commercial passenger flights, which was to end on June 30, will remain in place till July 31, 2021. However, the restrictions will not apply to international all-cargo operations flights that have been approved by DGCA. It also said that international scheduled flights may be allowed on selected routes by the competent authority on case-to-case basis. Scheduled passenger international flights were first banned in March 2020 due to COVID-19 pandemic. While domestic flights resumed in May, international travel remained suspended as COVID-19 cases remained. After many migrant workers infected with COVID-19 were reportedly abandoned at the Public Health Ministry pre-admission center in Bangkok. It is now temporarily closed to migrant workers at the center is used to screen people who are infected with the virus before sending them to a facility for treatment. Department of Medical Services Director General says the department is not based against migrant workers while hospitalization is available to everyone in Thailand regardless of nationality. Many of the recent COVID-19 cases have been clustered in the crowded places such as factories and construction camps, affecting migrant communities who often live in packed housing like worker informational settlements. Health officials have used a so-called bubble and seal method at some factories and construction camps that have reported outbreaks, often setting up a field hospital on site. Construction camp in Bangkok and surrounding provinces as well as in Thailand's deep south near the Malaysia border have been ordered to close for the next 30 days to contain the spread of the coronavirus.